like ball bags. Besides, I got something to say, and all y'all can't get y'all ball bags. If I ain't a hot boy, then what do you call? Just speaking in general, boy, there is no formidable opponent or adversary. Never step on it. When you wanna mind the kind of give it hope when they down and out. Dig a hole so deep, ain't no climbing out.
Yeah, I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but just the best. Don't you see me out here shining, better flexing? I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, and it's the best. And even if we die today, don't live forever. Live forever.
Yo, listen, just like I told Coco, my vision is vision. You already know though, so go, slow, that my logo, for sure, Coco,
get down on the,
Yo, listen, just like I told Coco, my vision is vision. You already know though, so go, slow.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Today's matchup features the top scoring pass offense in the NFL. The Eagles are top 10 in passing TDs, and they'll go against the Vikings, who are very aware of what they'll be dealing with.
It is a snowy and blustery day in the city of brotherly love as we welcome you to Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Minnesota Vikings and the Philadelphia Eagles. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here on first down, over the middle, complete. It's Sherman, 12 yards there as they move the chains. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen, but everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they showed to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. Now they go screen. It's complete. A big hit. Knocked down sideways. A nice little screen. They get six on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Rudolph, the tight end, in motion. A first carry now for Dalvin Cook. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. A three-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. Fullback tried to push the pile, and he lost the football, and the Eagles have recovered.
We've got plenty of weather here today. We've got some snow going on, and they've come out of a dome, and there have been two ways of getting ready for this. Some have said, don't worry about the weather. Just practice in your normal conditions and handle it on game day. And others have said, find some weather, find some conditions somewhere, and try and get ready. What do you think?
Well, whatever the preparation there, the snow causing the fumble. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Wentz. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. Now Wentz. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Pass the 20. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 44 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Now they'll send a tight end in motion left. Throwing his Wentz. And it's intercepted at the goal line. A great read and it's picked off. And nothing there on the return. They've got the football, but they'll have to start this drive at their own four-yard line. Really nice pick there for the reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week, and a good story on that. He said he didn't even know he won the award. His buddy had to call him. He saw on television and said, hey, congratulations. How about that?
And I'll bet you his buddy said, well, since you didn't know, I'll just go ahead and claim the award, right, and everything that goes along with it. But the reason he won the award the previous week and what we just saw there, instincts, understanding where the play is going and being able to make a play on the football.
They start the drive with Cook. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. This running game's so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity. And that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now, we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Looking for his tight end, Rudolph, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Raekwon McMillan. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can grab it.
He's got a man complete, and he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. It's a big one there for the Vikings. 45 yards. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Garoppolo now, first down throw, eluding the pressure right, and he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Second and 10. And Rudolph has it left side. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 23. The reception good for 7. It's third down. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. To throw once more, and he's got Kyle Rudolph, and he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run with Cook, and he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And it's no good. He misses the extra point, and this remains a 7-6 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. J.J. Nelson now to return. And they'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a 2-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs. So they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11. On play action, it's Wentz rolling to his right. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment. But here, he's one that has to absorb the contact. And as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
And they'll be in search of 11 yards here on third down. Throwing now is Wentz. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Burton. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. He takes this for about six down inside the 40.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Second down. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Brashad Perriman, and it's third down.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
A first update now out of Jacksonville. And the Jags, they're out to an early lead there. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. From the gun on third down, Wentz. Oh, he almost had the rare interception. The big fella couldn't hang on, though. Incomplete.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. This will be from 56 yards out. And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one, as it's good from 56 yards out. So it's a seven-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front seven. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. Play fake here on first down. He sets to fire deep. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
What I loved about meeting with these coaches before the game is we didn't even have to ask any questions. They told us that they were going to be aggressive and push the ball downfield. They weren't successful on that play, but look for them to try it again later.
And on second and 10 now. Garoppolo to throw. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Derek Barnett in there to get him, and that's sack number six for him on the year. So the sack of Garoppolo, and now what can they come up with on third and long? Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers.
Hurry up, here we go. No. Check. Patriot. Let's go. Watch it now, Barney.
Check.
Third and long, it's Garoppolo. Over the middle here to Rudolph. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And let's not take for granted, in these conditions, that's never an easy pass and catch.
You really got to find a way to drive the ball. You know, get your grip. You know, that's why we see some of the guys now that put the gloves on when they throw the ball in this type of a condition. Sometimes the glove might make it too slippery. So you've got to figure out what's going to work for you. But how about the receivers? Looking back and trying to locate the ball coming through snow and making sure they have full concentration.
On first down, Garoppolo. And his throw here's incomplete. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver. And now it's second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And complete. Right side, the tight end Rudolph. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He had told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it. I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end. But running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Second down, Cook. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
They run again on first down, Cook. And he'll get a couple here down to the 22.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Second down, here's Garoppolo. Over the middle, complete. It's Sherman. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. First down, here's the run with Cook. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get his second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Now they'll send a tight end in motion left. They try again with Cook. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you're
without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
The offense on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and goal. Minnesota. A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are able to strike for 6. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already had it lined up. Never even got to it.
And they will line up now for the 2-point try.
Hurry up, here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
Throwing now is Garoppolo. And that is incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a 2-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And the reception made by Alshon Jeffrey. An Eagle first down, Wentz hooking up with Jeffrey.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice gain.
Minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. Here's Ajayi. And nothing doing here is this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a 3rd and long situation coming up. Twins. The connection here with Nelson Agholor. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's 4th down. So now on is Caleb Sturgis for the Eagle field goal. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So now on is Caleb Sturgis for the Eagle field goal. Made his first, this now from 46 yards away. missed it. That was neither far enough. It wasn't even on target. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is. And there is nothing easy about being a kicker on a day like this.
Yeah, I tell you, not only is the footing tough in the snow, but kicking that ball is like kicking a rock. Very difficult to get any sort of feel on your kicks.
Garoppolo on first and 10. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Sidney Jones. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
And this might not be the last interception we see, Brandon. Both of these teams like to throw the football, but here in this snow, ball's not going to always go where you want it to. And this one winds up getting intercepted.
An NFL update, second quarter now in Jacksonville. The Jaguars extending their lead to a couple of touchdowns now. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. So after the INT, here's Wentz. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down at the 49. And the offense lining up first and 10. Working from the gun, Wentz. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. 14 yards that time for number 14.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and, of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Wentz now on first down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Fresh set of downs here. They go play action here on first down. Hurts over the middle. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Again, they'll throw with Wentz. That's complete right around the 8. And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a 3rd and goal. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it. So on comes the field goal unit from the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And Sturgis able to knock it through. Meanwhile, down in Dallas, and it's the Cowboys that have moved down to an early advantage. Dak Prescott with 2 first-half touchdown passes. Now it's Sturgis converted on the field goal. Now he'll send this one away on the kickoff. Short, short kick. One of the up middle take it now. And now running right through it. So we've come to halftime here in Philly with the Eagles on top as we send you down to Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as he'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Let's see if they do just that. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Second down here after the incomplete pass. This is Ajayi. Oh, now he bowls him over. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
On first down, Wentz. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Anthony Barr leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye. That happened fast and a big sack. To throw on second down. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage here back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Got some real estate inside the 30, and he's going to get this inside the 30. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
On play action, Wentz. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Lion, Lion. Switch. Here we go.
On second down, here's Wentz. And the pressure gets to him again. Everson Griffin in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Time running out here on the play clock. Wentz going to throw. In the middle of the field, he's got Nelson. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Now this will be the 9th play on this drive. They run with Ajayi. And he'll get 4 there, down to about the 12-yard line.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
And the seemingly endless drive continues. It's an end around with Perriman. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense get a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. Now they'll run it on the toss, and he's in for an Eagles touchdown. A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles had 6 to their lead. And with that, the lead is up to 8. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. So here we go, first and 10 now. A toss to Cook, and he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. They run it again with Cook, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up 3rd.
Doesn't take any great analysis on my part. It's been pretty obvious. Last couple of plays, these guys have been going in the wrong direction.
Offensive line overwhelmed on those plays. Now, I think it's safe to say going to the air here on 3rd. So first and second down went in the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13.
Let's go. Boom, landed.
Working from the gun, Garoppolo. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
On the NFL scoreboard, third quarter now from Jacksonville. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. This is brought in at the 21. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. So dangerous with a football in his hands. Call that a return of 38. And the Eagles will have great starting field position here as they take over. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Wentz now on first down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles in possession of the football and leading this one as we get ready to start the final quarter. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. Now Wentz throwing on second down. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Now we'll get a stoppage here as it appears we've got an Eagle slow to get up. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Well, for last week's performance, which was so good, he was named NFC Defensive Player of the Week. He got a lot of praise, and understandably so, from national media. Looking pretty good on that play, too.
And I love what he told us this week before the game. He talked about how much time they spend working on pass rush moves every position, because anyone could go after the quarterback in their defense, and you can see how they've all observed their lessons.
Wentz got his man complete over the middle. That's Nelson, and he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. The Eagles on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Now Wentz. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
So that's a big one there. It's his third field goal of the game, and a 2-score lead's got to feel pretty good right about now.
And while they're not free and clear yet, you're right. Now this defense can go out knowing that it's going to take more than one big play to catch them.
Now it's Sturgis converted on the field goal. Now he'll send this one away on the kickoff. This is taken near the 13. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And now out comes Minnesota. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Rudolph, the tight end, in motion.
Over.
Garoppolo now, first down throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for his tight end there, Kyle Rudolph. And that'll bring up second down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
It's Garoppolo over the middle here to Rudolph. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Now Garoppolo on the bootleg. They'll roll him out right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Garoppolo looks to throw once more. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, it's one thing to complete that pass on a nice sunny 70-degree day, but in these elements, that's a tough thing to do.
It is, and let's just put the whole thing together, not just throwing the ball, trying to protect the quarterback now when you got the pass rushers coming at you and maybe things are a little slippery on the field. The guys trying to cover downfield, wanting to make sure they keep their footing as the guys make their cuts, looking back and locating the ball. You name it, it's difficult all the way around, but the guy throwing it, he may have the toughest task.
First is Garoppolo, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And he'll be taken down at the 34. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and nine.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. So they're operating in the red zone. Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be second and 11. Garoppolo now. Yeah, quick throw here. That's complete. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. The Vikings on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Just a yard, but that's all they needed. And by the slimmest of margins, it'll be 1st and goal.
Man, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was 3rd and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Kyle Rudolph, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Vikings are able to make this a close game again. So now here are the Vikings faced with a big 2-point conversion attempt.
That's Hepburn! Hepburn!
Now Garoppolo. And he will get into the end zone as a 2-point conversion is successful. And the lead is down to a field goal here in the 4th. So time here for the onside kick and then the 2-minute warning. Whistles now in a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the 2-minute warning. So time here for the onside kick and then the 2-minute warning. Dodge a bullet. They cover it up. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Rashad Perriman, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles add on to their lead. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. His guys will take a 10-point lead. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
10 yards still left on second down. Throw is Garoppolo. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pick up there of 20 yards. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw, Garoppolo. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. So second and 10 here.
All right, here we go.
And the slot man goes in motion left. Sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
The Vikings on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third and 10. And yet again, it's Garoppolo. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. They're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Here we go now. Watch it now, Barney.
Now Garoppolo. Got to have this one. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Charles Harris in there to bury him for a loss of 11. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that
They're
one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And last time, able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Jay Ajayi, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles had six to their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face, and I'm thinking, I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Sturgis out now to kick this one off. This is taken near the 13. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there. Hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play. But if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all of that yardage. That would be a big play.
Garoppolo to try again on second down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Charles Harris. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. On third and long, it's Garoppolo. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Well, he bounced up after taking a sack and took a shot downfield. I think a lot of us thought maybe he'd run draw in that situation. Instead, tried to get all back in one play.
Yeah, third and long, thought he needed the deep pass, couldn't connect it.
Maybe he was hoping for a penalty downfield to give him the yardage they needed.
Try it here. He's back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is going to be incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Eagles are likely going to win it. And out now come the Eagles. Two timeouts remaining defensively, but that shouldn't make much difference right here.
It really shouldn't, but a lot of coaches look at it similar to baseball with the intentional walk.
Always bringing in other
sports. Always, hey, listen, think about the intentional walk, right? What if one gets past the catcher? What if he uncorks a wild one and now you still have an opportunity? That's why they like to use them all the way through.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. Well, partner, there's something special about a game in the snow. Just always fun in these elements, although a little chillier up here in the open-air booth. The only thing that's not fun is that we got the mid-game notification that our flight was canceled tonight, but we'll deal with that later. It was really a fun game to watch, though.
It was, and there is something special about games played in the snow because the element of surprise really kicks in. You don't know how they're going to handle the ball, if someone's going to make a dramatic play just out of nowhere, and all of a sudden it just changes the course of things. But a big shout-out to our crew to make sure that we were comfortable up here, as comfortable as one could be. In these elements, they took care of us and made sure we were dressed properly.
So for the Eagles, the win gets them back over 500 at 5-4 on the year. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Arizona Cardinals. Meanwhile, for Minnesota, their season is on life support somewhat now at 3-6. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week at home against Jacksonville. So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Eagles are winners here as we say so long from Philadelphia.
stay myself, I never change. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Do whatever get you paid. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I still long. Got 100 different in my cell phone. Still 33, 4 long. Ride to my dog sitting in jail. Is that lighter on the ground, spin it back, roll. I'm on Keller, I'm on Special, I'm on Flat Show. I'm at Magic, I'm at Polish, let them go. Then it's right back to the when I'm low. Bars never close and we wide open. Kicking flavor with me, neighbor, yeah, we local. Rap the bottom, cause the bottom where we come from. Me no pray for little paper, need a lump sum. Real spiel, yeah, I would rather be, yeah. Broke, real, real, little rich. Fall in love with her, she just wanna be a VIP. With her. Don't blame me, oh, they just shake me. Had to get it, how I got it, on my phone to be. Don't blame me, I'm what the game made me. Not what the fame made me, I won't let it change me. I'm the same man.
Myself, I never change, yeah, yeah, yeah. Dirty started treat me like a stain, yeah, yeah, yeah. Do whatever get you paid, yeah, yeah, yeah. Rolling from the cradle to the grave, yeah, yeah, yeah.
On my hood, on my block, yeah. On my, I won't stop, yeah. Play with me, I'll let it, yeah. Halo on me, say LeBron, yeah.
More than life, take advantage. We gon' get this money, stack this paper, and be on. keep on business on sight. On sight.
I go out for my squad and I put that on,
squad.
All I got is my word and my word is my bond.
Squad.
Yeah. They gon' look at you different when you moving far. But just stick to the code, you get yours, I get mine.
Polo to the float out. You already know though. It's Adamville for real. You see ya, just take a photo. I'm reppin' as I'm photo with a on your bro though. Grow that dodo, thought that he could rob a player for some dodo. Oh no, also Allen Temple, also England Manor, also Misty Valley, and I got a couple yesterday out of Cali. Am I bad from the valley? Bought me brand new Balance. Better play what a no American dream. Man, she been riding since her daddy rode on four. I done in every hotel and every ain't with my wife, but if she meet her, might be a go.
Big flat, red flat, flashy. Don't I look dashy? Don't I look classy? Don't act so sassy. I'm the man, boo. That's with or without you. With what your say? Show me what that.
I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but it's the best. Hey, don't you see me out here shining, barely flexing. I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but it's the best. And even if we die today, gon' live forever. Live forever.
Daddy Pat say with three X's. Take the exit, no exit on my chest, but all these diamonds got me blessed. Usually I don't do this, dumb it down, go stupid. Since 17, been counting M's, my bank account's on goofy. Say, gave up. Now who know what the truth is? Chicago full of, my garage is full of hoop. This got that southern draw and all that. My like ball bass. The South got something to say, and all y'all can't get y'all ball back. If I ain't a hot boy, then what do you call sacks? Daddy Pat, y'all never ball back. Like clocks in the wintertime, we stay eating like it's dinner time. Been feasting, big, but it ain't no rhyme. We don't know the meaning of drought, cause we keep it so wet, boy, I swear now, it's been a while. Just speaking in general, boy, there is no formidable opponent or at that bonnet. Never step on it. When you wanna mind the kind of giving hope when they down and out. Dig a hole so deep, ain't no climbing out.
I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but it's the best. Don't you see me out here shining, barely flexing. I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but it's the best. And even if we die today, don't live forever. Live forever.
Yo, listen, just like I told Coco, my vision is vision. You already know though, so go slow. That's my logo, for sure, Coco.
Get down on the. Yo, yo, listen, listen. Just like I told Coco, Coco, my vision is vision. You already know though. No, so go, go, slow, slow. Back my logo, logo, for show, for show, Coco. Now get down, down on that.
Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Then I get my buddy nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show him how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show him how to act. Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his man's hands in his hand, feeling like a man. Run, put him, put it to your brain like. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about, I know I can live without it. Red light, stop, green light, go. Everything ain't what it seem like, I know. Hold up, what you mean? Where you been in? This is merely the beginning again. What you been living in? A box under the bridge, like Anthony Kiedis, looking for something to complete us and maybe lead us. A long way from equalists, how they treat us. Body of a builder with the mind of a fetus. Turn on the television and see the vision they feed us. And I wish I could erase that face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love. Everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know. I've been knocking dough down like it witness. God is my witness, I'm witness, but on the real I think I need another witness. If it was 17, black daddy, white mama wouldn't change a thing. Light skin certified as a house. Go figure, and my blood is the venom master. It's like the devil playing spades with the pastor.
But he was born with the privilege.
Man, what the fuck is that? People told me as a child, as a little boy playing with his toys, I should be ashamed. And some people look ashamed when I rap, like my great granddaddy didn't take a pickle to the back. Not accepted by the bottom, cuddle. I don't give a fuck, praise God, I can see the light. Everybody talk about race this, race that. I wish I could erase that, face facts. Everybody, people. Everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know. Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now.